Honorable Mrs. Shaked, Minister of Justice of the State of Israel, dear ladies and gentlemen, my name is Vince Wittler, the Vice Dean of the Law. I want to wish you a warm welcome at the Faculty of Law of the University of Vienna, where you are giving a lecture today, thank you for that, on the invitation of my dear colleague Peter Lewisch. There have been some discussions in the forefront of this lecture, and for example, an open letter demanding that the University of Vienna should cancel this lecture, since, as we know, there are a lot of discussions concerning the politics in the Middle East, and especially the politics of the State of Israel. I do not want to take any position in that discussion, but to say one thing clear. A university, and especially a faculty of law, is to be a place of free speech, where also, especially, controversial opinions can and should be expressed and discussed. And that opinion I want to express as my personal opinion. It would be a total wrong sign, and it would be wrong in itself if we would not allow the Minister of Justice the State of Israel to express her view here in Austria and at the Faculty of Law, given the history of Austria and the history of the University of Vienna in the 30s and 40s of the past century. So once again, a very warm welcome, Mr. Kitson.
Dear guests, Excellency, I would like to introduce today's speaker. More formal sense, we have an extraordinary person before us. She is Minister of Justice of the State of Israel and has a degree in computer science and electrical engineering. She has not studied law, but she's doing law now for many years. Her Excellency Mrs. Shaked has joined politically the Office of the Jewish Zionist Party and has been the first woman and the first secular person to be elected in the party's primaries for the list for the general elections, and then has been elected first on the list in the general elections for the Knesset, another quite important thing. She has also sponsored a movement for accurate information in the internet, another thing that I think is worth mentioning, and among the manifold legal activities that, of course, a Minister of Justice runs should just be mentioned that apart from the formal position as the head of the respective department, she's also chairing the Committee for Legislation and the Committee for Judicial Decision-Making, right, for the election of judges. Having said all this, we now are expecting a presentation with a discussion to follow to a subject matter that is not only intrinsically interesting, but has drawn the attention of all the audience here. These are tough questions, and we are very much looking forward to your presentation. And then afterwards, I will, in a sense, lead the discussion, collect questions, and Her Excellency is so kind as I think to have reserved a reasonable amount of time for this discussion, and we are very much looking to the active exchange of views on these subject matters. So, Your Excellency, the floor is yours. A warm welcome.
Thank you very much. Actually, for me, it also wasn't that easy to come and speak at the University of Vienna. Personally, I must confess, I never been in Austria till I was elected to a minister, and it wasn't a coincidence. I thought it's not a place to do a vacation because of the history, but after I was elected and met some of the Australian ministers and Austrian ministers and parliament members, I decided to come and visit, and actually I enjoyed very much, and I think that after really so many years, it's good to have an open dialogue. So thank you for the warm hospitality. Actually, I prefer, I will give a short lecture, I prefer more to do an open discussion. I would like also to hear the the view of the student here on many topics, so I will start with a short lecture and then we will move to open discussion. You can ask me any question you want. In Israel, unlike in Austria, we have an adversary system, legal system, and there is ongoing conflict between the judicial system, the government, and the parliament. I just heard that the Supreme Court canceled the election for the presidency, and I was in shock, actually. And I thought to myself, oh, okay, they are also very activists, it's not only in Israel. So there is ongoing tension between the government, the parliament, and the judicial system. I am the head of the committee that selects judges. In Israel, the system is that there is a committee of 9 members, representative of the government, of the parliament, of the bar association, and of the Supreme Court. And they choose, we are choosing the judges. Next week, we have a very important meeting because we are going to select 4 judges out of...
Sorry for interrupting you.
No.
Sorry for
no.
part of the government in Israel. And your colleague, Naftali Bennett, said, I killed many Arabs and
come on,
there's
come
no
on.
Problem. And he is not only your party colleague.
You are a guest. You are a guest in here.
Can you sit down
and
speak?
And your government is responsible for the killing of thousands
and the
Palestinians in the Gaza
Strip
and the
missile
destruction
of because you're interested in shouting lies without knowing the
fact. This is a fact. And you as a minister of
you
are responsible direct for house demolition.
The facts.
For collective punishment, and
you want to listen for facts?
And house demolition in Israel, in the Nakab and in the north, that so-called unrecognized,
this is not the behavior. This is not the behavior. Sit down.
I think you should ask.
I say you are not welcome in Australia. This is not Australia.
So after 75 years, continue with lies.
I really need to tell you, I really need to tell you, and in the West Bank. It's illegal.
Nein,
thank you. And I want to say, this event promotes racist policies.
Those 9 members selecting the Supreme Court judges.
And this event will legalize.
And next week we are going to
house demolitions, collective punishment, and institutionalized torture of prisoners. Last week, your newspaper Haaretz said that institutionalized torture
and
ignorance about human rights.
You want to eradicate human rights in Europe and also in the world. You want to eradicate human rights standards in Europe. Sorry, I have to say this. This is a fact. We can talk about your active service in the Golani Brigade.
That you are after 75 years continue with the lies that you are reading in the media.
4, 10,
and trying to promote
all like Naftali Bennett, no problem.
Sorry of you. Pity, thank you. Now you start in German. It sounds better in German.
Okay.
So there is ongoing tension between the judicial system and the parliament and the government. Next week is a very unique week because we are going to select 4 judges out of 15 for the High Court. And the Supreme Court in Israel is only one. We have a very strong and professional High Court that actually did everything, both with the constitutional issues and with the appeals. Actually, they are having one they are having 10,000 files a year. And it's very, I would say, unique system. A very good example of the ongoing tension between the High Court, the Parliament, and the government, actually like in every other country, is the law that the Knesset legislated 4 years ago, 5 years ago, a law that dealing with the illegal immigrants. So the Knesset, in Israel, there was a situation in which 60,000 illegal immigrants came from Africa, from Sudan and Eritrea, to the southern border to Israel. And legislate a law, something that we copied mainly from Australia, and that if an illegal immigrant is coming to Israel, we can put him in a detention center for 3 years. The Supreme Court canceled the law. The Knesset, the parliament, legislated again for a year and a half. We softened the law. Then the Supreme Court canceled it again, and we legislated again for 6 months. Which is actually like in all the rest of the of Europe, the different illegal immigrants is coming, you can put him for a detention center for 6 months. And it's great high tension between the court and the government, but of course we are doing what the court is saying to do. We soften the law, and actually we start we succeed to stop the illegal immigration by the law and by a fence that we built in the southern border. Now, I met your Minister
during
of Justice.
In the 2014 Gaza War, you posted an unpublished piece by the late right-wing journalist, Uri Elitzur, calling for war against the entire Palestinian people. These are your words, including, quote,
it was
quoting
not
you.
My words.
It was words
again,
that you posted on Facebook.
Again, another lie you said to the
it's
public
elderly
and
women
yourself,
in it's elderly
it
women in cities,
my
it's
words.
Villages, it's property,
but you can continue
and it's infrastructure.
Lie to yourself, it's fine.
It was words that you posted in a Facebook status. I'm going to take
okay,
off the endorsement
so
of these words. This
yes.
is your quote.
That,
the Palestinian people has declared war on us, and we must respond with war.
A fence in the
not
south,
an operation, not a slow moving one, not low intensity,
illegal immigration,
not full escalation,
was a huge
no destruction
success,
of terror,
I would say.
No terror and destruction,
and
no
people
target killing.
All over the world
enough
are coming
references.
To Israel to study
this is a
how to do it.
It is not a war against terror, and not a war against extremists, and not
yes,
even a war against the
Minister of Justice, and I
these two are forms of avoiding reality.
English version of the law against terror, and it took us 7 years to work on this law in the Israeli parliament. It's a law that the government submitted to the parliament, and for 7 years there were discussions regarding this law, and the thing that I will say the most difficult thing is, and a question that I think most now of the Western country deal with, is how to keep a strong democracy on one hand and fight the terror on the other end, when sometimes the terrorists are also citizens of the country. And this is a huge challenge for any Western country.
We want to respect
for one reason human rights. For one reason to respect the human rights. And on the other hand, as a democracy that needs to defend themselves, to know how to defend, how to defend.
Shame on Magna,
how to defend the citizens from terror attacks.
Israel is a criminal apartheid state. Apartheid is well defined.
You're a liar. You're a liar. But in a Western country of freedom of speech, I respect your lies, but you're a liar.
Some people even accuse Israel of committing
the main
according to a recent UN report, by the year 2020, Gaza will become unhittable.
The main challenge is to balance the human rights.
It is not fit for human consumption.
Okay, so
the main challenge is to balance human rights
on one hand, and of course to fight terror on the other hand. And I'll give you an example of administrative detention. Administrative detention is a powerful tool that a country can use, and we are using it very delicate way, on a regular basis, that from intelligent perspective, we don't want the country doesn't want to take a specific person to a trial because the country doesn't want to expose a material that had been given by the intelligence, but to take someone to administrative detention. In Israel, what we did is we show all the material to the judge, and also the person can take a defender, and the judge approved to put a specific terrorist to administrative detention. It's a very severe tool, but we are doing it from time to time, again in very specific cases. Another question that we are dealing with, and I know that a lot of Western countries dealing with, I just heard that France and Australia...
I do not apologize for interrupting you again, but you are a representative of a racist apartheid regime. And it's outrageous that the University of Vienna is giving you the place to say your racist and apartheid things. Yes, it's outrageous. And you shouldn't be there. You are not welcome in Austria. You are not welcome in Vienna. You are the representative of a racist regime. You are practicing apartheid, and I don't accept it. It's unacceptable. It's unacceptable. Shame on the University of Vienna for inviting you, a representative of the apartheid regime. No apartheid. Free Palestine. Free Palestine.
So, thank you. Polizei. Ja, gerne.
Sehr gerne.
Ja, sehr gerne.